Whew, okay, sunny day in Munich, Olympia Park, or Olympiasen Zentrum. And what we have here is the BMW Museum. So let's just see what this has to offer. Museum that way. They do, but I don't know if you can see all the curves and different angles and things, because these GoPros tend to flatten things out. They're flat earthers. So parked down there. I went past the place to start with. I've got a feeling we're going over there. So I sat and there was saying go there, and I thought, oh, it's show the sign for here. So I'm probably in the wrong place, but hey, get some steps in as well. Doesn't hurt. Was in the wrong place. As you can see, it says museum over there. So we'll wait until they let me cross. Mm-hmm. Well, there we go. So, yeah, all good. We'll see what we have to offer. Obviously, it's going to be full up with cars. There might be some bikes there too. I'm happy either way. Obviously, been driving cars for 30 odd years. Well, more than 30 odd years, but for the last 30 odd years, only cars. So it's not like I don't like cars. It's just I wanted to a set of two wheels again. So here we go. See. Hello, fella. There we go. And if it's shut, I can just grab a coffee. So, if you can't read that, the history of BMW motorcycles began in 1923. Members of the company's staff, who happened to be enthusiastic motorcyclists, convinced the management that motorized two-wheelers offered great sales potential. Engineers and skilled personnel had transferred the high-quality standards they applied to the company's aircraft, engines, to the new product, thus gaining BMW a deserved place in the premium segment of the market. Already got the opposed engine. A 500cc, 6.5 brake horsepower, boxer flat twin. Okay. Whoa, as you go down there's more. Ah, oh, yeah. I love the fact that from the start they had a drive shaft as opposed to chains. Now, I don't know if there was any issue with having a drive shaft on a bike. I don't see it as a bad thing. If you can create a decent drive shaft. And these guys have been doing it for a long, long time. But let's see. Mm-hmm. Bouncing up and down. They certainly engineer things nicely. Okay, so so this must have been a 328 over here, 1939, maybe, looks like it. Phone for it, it's obviously not a heavy fan. Okay. So, obviously they started off with ovals, and there we got flame-proof protection. And these things apparently drive along the wall. So this beast of a motor, obviously on a aquaplane type of vessel. I'm guessing that's just been put there as an indication of the size of the crankshaft. And then we've got the plane engine. Mr. Milliard would love one of those, I'm sure. One of those other ones, but this is a double, like a twin. If you J engines. Okay. This place is like a maze. You have to sort of go back as if you're exiting to go down another level. So, but they're the sort of BMWs of my youth. 1975. So I would have been, well, I wouldn't have been able to drive, that's for sure. But they were the sort of things that were that you'd be looking at when you could drive. They were the things that you aspired to. Oh. Free injection, lovely. Always fancy one of those. Never got one, mind. There's a lot of nice BMWs about. And they built a nice motor. I'm surprised the one at the end there looks a bit like the 2002 TII that I had, but obviously it's a earlier model of something less powerful, but lovely. That's when you start to get all bulbous. Lost a bit of interest then. These were the models I liked. Pretty much as soon as they make something, the humans want to race them. Attempt bike, no doubt. Ernst Jakob N, the fastest man in the world. So that was 279,000 2,503 kilometers an hour. That seems extremely, unless that's 279 kilometers an hour. Okay. Well, I'm just going to say BMW, you've messed this one up because you've put the steering wheel and there isn't even a seat there. Oh dear. Air in, pretty sharp, into the cylinders, right down here. Boom, 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 boom. Timing gear, clutch. Catalytic converter. I'm sure they can design these things quickly, look at that. Posing the most big in a day. Clever design. Okay. So here we have. This must be like the. So you've got your battery bit in there, inverter, and an engine. It regenerates. Yeah. They're not toys. Jury's out on that one. Mm-hmm. 30. This is when they started to get a little bit sexy, didn't they? Aren't they 56? Got to admit to looking at these in the second hand market from time to time. And my cousin had one of those. Was it Z4? Okay. Oh, I'll tell you what's in here. So, this little beauty, and I had one of these when I was about 20, 20 or 22, 2002 Ti. Mine was orange too. So, well, it's not to like. Apart from people that didn't know anything about it, thought it looked like a Polski Fiat. I tell ya. Okay. 3 series at the bottom there. 5 series, 6 series, and 7 series. Engines. So these ones going to Le Mans, etc. Literally no creature comforts in these things. They're built to get around as fast as possible. And the less weight, the better. Oh, okay. Funny, but they're all winning things. Okay. So this is about being designed in wind tunnels and things. That one's a bit like a brick. CSI. Yeah. It was just sought after back in the day. Okay.
The BMW R5 is fascinating. The BMW R5 is
apparently 2019, a Batoni. Really? Based on a 2002, was it? That one looks a bit funkier. Okay, we're going uphill. Okay. What's this then? Really? Have I missed something? No.
Thank you.
So the last thing to do at the BMW place is obviously enjoy a BMW coffee and muffin. There we go. See you next time.